Hey, howdy, hey, monster hunters, how's it all going? So, don't be alarmed, even though I did say the video title is I can't play Monster Hunter Tri-Ultimate, it's not that I actually can't play it. I've kind of screwed myself over by only using a Switch Axe a majority of the time. And I'll tell you why. So, as you can see in most of the videos that I have been posting, I've more or less been using the same armor set, the same weapon constantly. But the reason for that was is because all the other weapons I have were more or less low rank or high rank equivalents, in that I was still trying to get all the parts to more or less upgrade them into what they should be. Now, I have kind of done that, but the other reason is also that, which you've also noticed, I've only been using Zoroathalos armor for the majority of the quests. So I have actually managed to get a couple other sets, and now it's just a case of trying to actually use the other weapons. I mean, I don't know, I suppose at the beginning of Monster Hunter I did kind of get into lances, and when I say beginning I mean like Monster Hunter 1, the original Monster Hunter, but that was only because lances at the time were so OP that you could headlock a Rathalos constantly, or even lock at the wings. Now, obviously you can't really do that anymore as such, but it was something interesting at the time. So what I've been doing at the moment is been mainly using katanas actually, and I have a feeling that most people say, well, katanas are still OP so you might as well not use them, but well, you're not wrong there, but it's a change from using a Switch Axe all the time, for me at least anyway now. And I've also made, actually this is where, if you guys were on Facebook you would have seen the Skype chat screenshot where I was talking to Icicle about this. I managed to get the Great Kelby shot, slingshot or bow, whatever you want to call it, and the armor set that usually goes with it, which is the Helios X armor set. So that will take a bit of getting used to, even though I was killed twice by a rampaging Rathalos at one point, which was always fun. but yeah, I'm kind of branching away from using a Switch Axe. I'm mainly using a katana now. I really want to get into using hammers, because I think that was one of the things I was mainly using in Portable Third at the time when I was playing with other people online. So might get back into that. Dual swords as well. They're apparently really good on Tri-Ultimate with the Brachydios slime element, which more or less everything with the slime element is pretty good. So it'll be worth trying to use that really. And I mean, that will be kind of half of the actual video, trying to branch away from using a Switch Axe, in which I've kind of screwed myself over by only using it at the time. Now, the other part of this video, which you guys can see, is Uniqlo. Yeah, the clothes retailer has now got an online, well sorry, they have always had an online store, but part of their online store for the UK customers now has the Monster Hunter range, which is pretty awesome. They've got about, let's see off the top of my head, I think it was about 16 or so, anywhere between the ballpark of 10 to 20 different designs. I wouldn't say 20 though, maybe about 17 or so max, but they've got quite a few different shirt designs, so I've already placed my order for a couple of them already, because just in case they go out of stock or in case they don't sell them anymore, it's the easiest way to actually buy the shirts other than going to the international stores online and try to buy them and then get them sent here, which doesn't always work, but it's worth a try. So I mean, I thought that was pretty cool and, you know, worth mentioning as well. If anyone is interested, I'll drop a link into the video description of the actual store page. They did have an actual section for Monster Hunter 4 t-shirts, but for some reason it just doesn't work, so I'll just put the actual search of it in there. But I thought it was really cool. I'll pop up a few designs on the screen as well so you guys can see what sort of shirts that they are selling. There is one in particular which is like a Rathalos shirt, which on the front it will have I think it's a normal Rathalos looking at some dung. I don't know why. And then they've got a Rathalos on the back. In my opinion, that is the coolest shirt there by far. But they didn't have it in the size I wanted, so that kind of sucked. But I'm sure you guys can probably buy it in your sizes. For the female viewers, unfortunately, they only show the men's variant of the shirt. But if that does affect you in any such way that you would rather buy a men's shirt over a girl's shirt, by all means go for the men's one. But they haven't got a girl's one there as far as I know. So that kind of sucks. And pretty lucky escape there. Thought I was going to die in all honesty. But yeah, two things I wanted to talk about there. Actually, no, a third. If any of you guys did notice, I did do a live stream directly to YouTube, which people did say that it was a lot better than the Twitch stream, so I thought that was pretty cool. The chat system, in comparison to how I used to record Twitch by having the game chat recorded on a separate computer, because I couldn't really use the same one at the same time to actually read it as well, and then kind of edit it in with the video, was a bit different, but it looked quite promising, and I was able to do it, the actual stream, directly from the software. So you might see a stream maybe this weekend, maybe next weekend, most likely next weekend though, but I'll let you guys know. But yeah, streaming's on the way again, which is quite nice. We'll see how that goes, really. And if anyone does notice anything about this particular part of the video, you would have noticed that I did post a screenshot of said quest at the end of what I got, which, as you can see there, 3 Devil Joe gems from a quest which really wasn't about a Devil Joe. Sweet. Anyway, 2 videos on screen that you may have missed, more importantly the one at the very top, is Jake's Stream Fund video. Please check it out, have a listen to what the cause is about. And if you'd rather go there and vote without knowing, which by all means I would say to actually go there and find out, but to vote you only need a Google Plus account or a Facebook account to vote with. You can only vote once, unfortunately, but your vote will help and it will definitely make a difference there. So if you guys can check that video out there, it'll open in a new tab. Just check it out, listen. If you feel like voting, link will be in the description of that video. Just click it and click vote. So, yeah, I appreciate it, guys. Thanks for all the help so far, anyway. And I'll catch you guys next time. Bye.